This is Brian Quinones. This is Kobe Heisler, Amity's son with autism. Actually the day that Brian was killed, I was at the Capitol meeting with Attorney General Keith Ellison, letting him know if something doesn't happen, it's gonna be some retaliation. Yes. It's only so much we can take.
Yeah.
And so by that night, I had that with Chief Harrelson, I had that with Harrelson that morning and Keith Ellison at the Capitol, and by that night, Brian got killed.
Wow.
I was looking on Facebook, just scrolling, and lo and behold, this man is getting killed right there on live by Richfield police. This is Kobe Heisler, who we talked to, Amity's son, who had autism. This is Harnell Sherrill. This is Miss Delshia's son, who died in the jail. And I wanted to add to that, I watched those videos. They mistreated their son.
Mm-hmm.
He was
neglect.
He died slow.
Mm-hmm.
And they took him, threw him in a bed like he was a dog after he came from the hospital. It was horrific. This is Billy Hughes that was killed. He stepped outside and shot, St. Paul police shot him up. And his family, three other people, they killed four people in one family. The police here in Minnesota. Sorry, Miss Marilyn. This person, I'm still trying to figure out who it is. This person I actually do not know, but he was a victim. I think he's out of state. I think
Yes, he was. We went to that women's march.
Yeah.
And I met the person at that time, and they were sitting out talking to me.
Mm-hmm.
I was sort of touched by how that person got killed, so I took that picture.
Mm-hmm.
And thought maybe they would be here, but they left town.
Well, they didn't live here. So this is Jamar Clark. Of course, that's a popular one that a lot of people heard about. He was shot with the handcuffs on, shot in the back of his head. They tried to take the handcuffs off of him before the second ambulance, because another ambulance came. The ambulance was there first for a girl that got hurt that Jamar was checking on. And then the police came, shot him. The whole story, if you hear straight from the family, he did not hit the girl. There was not a fight with him and no female. She fell over at a party and he was checking on her in the ambulance. They called the police. The girl was saying, no, he didn't do nothing wrong. He's my friend. They showed up, got into it with him. They got him on the ground, put the handcuffs on him, ended up shooting him in the back of the head while he was handcuffed. And then there was a 10-year-old that seen the whole thing. They had to take that 10-year-old kid, move him out of Minnesota, so he's not even here. But the 10-year-old told everything, that they tried to take the handcuffs off before the other ambulance came, and that Jamar was already handcuffed when they shot him.
They found